Now let's meet tonight's starters. First, for the Antelopes. Starting at guard, number 11, Jamari Milstead. Starting at guard, number 23, Carlos Johnson. Starting at forward, number 4, Oscar Freyer. Starting at forward, number 43, Michael Finke. And starting at center, number 25, Alessandro Labor. The carpet and bring on the Mountaineer. Starting in a guard, a 6-foot freshman from Kokona, Wisconsin, number 5, Jordan McKay. Starting in a guard, a 6'7 junior from Vancouver, British Columbia, number 10, Jermaine Haley. Starting at a forward, a 6'7 freshman from Tacoma, Washington, number 11, Emmett Matthews. Starting at a forward, a 6'8 junior from Cincinnati, Ohio, number 15, Lamont West. And starting at a forward, a 6'10 freshman from Youngstown, Ohio, number 1, Derek Colbert. And now let's bring on the rest of the Mountaineers and coaching staff.
Four on that starting five that were not even in this program a year ago for head coach Bob Huggins, as he will try to lead West Virginia to its 15th victory of the season here. Mountaineers wearing their gold uniforms this evening, and Grand Canyon wearing black uniforms with purple numerals trimmed out in white. Tonight's game being brought to us in part by Little General Stores. Great prices in convenient places. Nice crowd on hand. There was a lot of speculation or wonder as to how this game would draw. And it's general admission. It's $10 seats. And it looks as though fans, Jay, have kind of said, yeah, I'm in. And the lower level, I'd have to say, is about 95% filled, which gives it a nice look. The upper level was supposed to be closed, but there is some seating now taking place in the upper portions of the Coliseum as well.
You know what, Tony? I think what happened was that West Virginia won two games in Kansas City, and that certainly did not hurt the first two wins before losing to Kansas in the semifinal.
Totally agree with you. Derek Culver and Bob Huggins exchange a hug as the Mountaineers get ready to go to work. WVU over the last several games obviously looks nothing like the team that it looked like back in January and in the early portion of February. And this is the Grand Canyon team, folks, that was just one victory away from going to the NCAA tournament. They lost in the championship of the WAC tournament, and they were so close. 20 wins on the season, and fifth consecutive year that Dan Marley has led his team to a 20-win year. Jermaine Haley and Emmett Matthews last out onto the court. It will be Derek Culver jumping it off against Oscar Freyer. Freyer 6'7", Culver at 6'10". Interesting matchup. With the size of Grand Canyon and two bigs that can shoot the ball from the perimeter, it will be a challenge. And the way this game is officiated will be absolutely huge because Derek Culver is going to be guarding out on the perimeter. Ready to go. On Taberski, the official, steps in between the two bigs. Resets himself. Holds the ball up. And the tip controlled by WVU's Culver into the hands of McCabe. And we are underway here at the Coliseum. Opening round of the CBI into the hands of Jermaine Haley. Delivers out to the left wing to the freshman McCabe. Alley-oop lob for Haley. Makes the catch. Shoots it. Misses. And the rebound is cleared by Laver. And into the hands of Damari Milstead, their sophomore guard out of Hayward, California. He'll handle the point. Man-to-man defense, West Virginia. Outside, Freyer going to let one go. Straight away three. Hits long off the back iron. Rebound corralled by Lamont West. Hands it over to McCabe. West Virginia's second possession of the game. Here's McCabe with it. Gives it out front. Lamont West open. He'll let that three ball fly. It hits off back iron. Bouncing high. Rebound collected by Grand Canyon on a run out. Here is Milstead pushing. Left side wing. Johnson fakes it into the corner. Finke for a three ball. Swished it. And it is 3-0. Grand Canyon scores the game's first points. Michael Finke's 35th three of the year. 1 minute in as McCabe brings the ball into the front court to the outside right wing. Here's Lamont West. Junior out of Cincinnati holds and looks. Man-to-man D by Grand Canyon. Haley gets it, drops it down inside. Culver makes the catch. Pump fakes on the block. Spins, puts one up. Shot rejected out of bounds by Labor. And West Virginia will maintain possession with 10 on the shot clock. The inbound on the baseline left.
Not double-teaming Culver early. They're not doing double-teaming.
Here's McCabe. Gets the ball into Lamont West on the near side wing. Fakes a handoff to McCabe. Jab steps. Now sets his feet. Shoots up a three. And he switched it to tie the game at three apiece.
Confident senior. Got a game off early.
59th three of the year for Lamont West. 90 seconds in, locked at three apiece as Milstead brings the ball into the front court. Gets it right side. Now to Freyer underneath against Matthews. Lays it up and in. Nice look from the big outside to Freyer. He gets his first two. It's 5-3 Grand Canyon. Back comes Jermaine Haley. Haley dribble handoff out front to Jordan McCabe. He gives the ball top circle. Taken out there by Emmett Matthews. He gives the ball to Haley. Haley cut off by Freyer. Sends it out to the right side to McCabe. Now they will double down on Culver. He gets through the double team. Goes up. Puts up the shot. Missed it. Rebound loose and it's controlled by Finke. Back comes Grand Canyon with a 5-3 lead. Damari Milstead into the front court. Milstead over a high ball screen lets a three ball fly. It's off back iron. No. Rebound collected by the smallest man on the floor, McCabe. Into the front court, pushing it to Lamont West. Sets his feet, forces up another three. He airballed that one. Finke rebounds. Back comes Grand Canyon. 5-3. Antelopes lead by two. Finke with it. Dribble handoff up top to Carlos Johnson. Dribbles over to the left side. Gives it to Milstead. Milstead gets a screen. Gives up his dribble early. Sends the ball down inside. Labor against Matthews. Turnaround jumper off lightly. And the rebound corralled by Derek Culver. Back comes West Virginia. The Mountaineers trailing by two all the way down. Pass caught under the basket by Lamont West. He has to take it out to the right side. Now hands it over to Jordan McCabe. McCabe resets the offense for WVU. Out front to Haley. 14 and winding shot clock. Left wing to Emmett Matthews. Matthews gives a look-see down inside. Now the clock inside of 10. Top circle to Culver. Now the clock's at 5. Culver seems unsure. Bounces it left side to Matthews. Gets by the defender. Takes it up. Lays it up and in. And Matthews ties the game at 5 apiece. And he'll have a chance at a three-point play. Foul calls against Carlos Johnson. That'll be his first.
What you have to do is you have to make Carlos Johnson work on defense. That's exactly what Emmett Matthews did that time with the drive to the hoop and won.
Matthews very quiet in the title game or the semifinal game against Kansas. He was held at just 5 points, puts up the free throw, and he converts on the three-point play. But what a game he had against Texas Tech in the quarterfinals with a career-high 28. West Virginia takes the lead 6-5, 3 minutes in. There's Milstead now working out front left side, guarded by McCabe. Now switched on to by Culver, tries to chase him out there. Now they're going to double him up. Milstead looks. Milstead throws it away. And Haley returns it, though. Now Milstead attacks. 14-footer gets blocked. Tipped into the air. Controlled by Matthews. Back comes West Virginia. Matthews bringing it into the front court. Matthews attacking. Lost the handle. Stolen away. Here's Carlos Johnson pushing. 4-on-2 break. Johnson to the rim. Layup shot. Good. And a foul.
Really bad basketball that time by West Virginia. Good basketball in the finish. Absolutely. By Grand Canyon.
Absolutely was. West Virginia very loose with the ball. Johnson the leading scorer for this Grand Canyon team on the board as he gives the Antelopes a 7-6 lead. Johnson ready. Puts it up. No. Long rebound tip controlled by Grand Canyon. Back out to Johnson. Johnson starts to attack. Ball knocked out of bounds and it will go to WVU. Turnover number two against the Antelopes.
Well, they're switching on defense, Tony. Grand Canyon doing a nice job on those switches. You got to use Culver more on the inside. Even though he's getting the double team, it's up to Culver to get position.
7-6 Grand Canyon by a point at 16-20. McCabe in the front court. West Virginia working at the basket to our left. Over to the far right side wing. This is West being guarded by Michael Finke. West holds it. Now delivers it top circle to Jermaine Haley. Haley guarded by Freyer. Very good defensive player. Back out right side. They go to West now right of the lane. Here's Derek Culver. Shot clock 6. They double him up. Down the baseline. Clock 5. Kicks it out to Haley. Haley with 2 on the clock with 1. Forces one up. It gets blocked. Nice defensive job. Finke takes the loose ball down for Grand Canyon. Hugs going to the bench. Back comes Damari Milstead. 7-6 Grand Canyon with a 1-point lead. Milstead bounces the ball left of the circle. Backing in. This is Laver against Culver. Lost the ball. Tipped around. Out of bounds. It goes to Grand Canyon at 15-41. We'll get our first media timeout of the evening. Grand Canyon 7, West Virginia 6 at 15-41. Back to the Coliseum after this. Brick Street, your business, your people, your company.
Card. Roster cards are available on the concourse of the Coliseum. All right, fans, on your feet, and let's see those dance moves.
Gone by, and it is Grand Canyon by a point, 7-6 early on. Grand Canyon at 50% from the field. They've made 3 of 6. West Virginia just 2 out of 8 to start this game off. Euro Suites Hotel, known for its impressive hospitality, friendly and attentive staff, always available to help make the most of your stay in Morgantown. Euro Suites Hotel, your comfort, their business.
There you go, Tony. Quick shooting by West Virginia has made that 2-for-8 happen. I think that West Virginia on one side, both teams are man-to-man defense. West Virginia's side of the basketball, they need to reverse the ball more, make the defense of Grand Canyon work harder than what they've had to work early.
Bob Huggins takes his seat. He's made one substitution now the lineup as Chase Harler has come on for Jermaine Haley. Side inbound for Grand Canyon. Carlos Johnson floats the ball in, taken there by Milstead. Milstead drives by. McKay puts on the brakes, rockets it out front. Here's a step-up three on rim and out. Rebound cleared by Matthews off the miss from Laver. Now into the hands of McKay. West Virginia with a chance to take the lead and an errant attempt on a pass. West not waiting for it. And the ball goes back over to Grand Canyon. West Virginia very, very sloppy here early on. Here's Milstead dropping it left side. Chased down by Laver against Culver. Starts to back him in. Down the baseline. They try to double him. Laver gives up his dribble. Back over to Finke now. Finke out front. Back over to Laver. Gets by Culver. But the drop step forces a shot up. He left it short. Gets his missed back. Ball gets swatted away. Tries it again against Culver. Gets him into the air. Puts it up and in. Alejandro Laver puts Grand Canyon up 9-6 on the other end. Here's McCabe. out front, centers up the ball. They'll start their offensive set. Three-point lead now for the Antelopes. West Virginia's not playing in rhythm. Now off the ball, we're going to get a foul call here against Grand Canyon, and they will tag that on Michael Finke. That'll become his first and the team's second.
Yeah, well, Knapper's into the ball game at the point guard for Jordan McCabe. I thought really that was a quick move. That ball should have been caught and handled by Lamont West, and it wasn't in transition.
But Matthews will inbound in front of that Grand Canyon bench. West Virginia early on in this game, down by three. We played 5 minutes and 15 seconds. Here's Brandon Knapper, his first opportunity. Knapper at double figures against Kansas, West Virginia's last game. He bounces it. Here's Culver. Culver to the bucket, puts a shot up, and he draws the foul there. And that's West Virginia's game plan in a nutshell right there. As they'll whistle that against Alessandro Laver, his first becomes the team's third. And Culver is a key here for West Virginia. West Virginia wants to get the ball down inside and get the bigs from Grand Canyon into foul trouble. Culver, no stranger to the foul line. He led the Big 12 Conference in free throw attempts. He took 129, which was more than 20 more than Jarrett Culver of Texas Tech. So he can get to the line. The key is making them on the season. He's at 59%.
And Grand Canyon's done a good job on this second one. It's up and out, but they've done a good job, Tony, of keeping Culver away from that low post.
All right, into the game now for Grand Canyon is Drexel, and off the ball, boy, this is not a good foul for West Virginia. Way out front, Derek Culver making contact with Alessandro Laver, and Culver now is going to get a ticket out. That's not where they need him to get a foul. 9-7 is the score. Grand Canyon with a two-point lead at 14-27. Ball's inbounded into the hands of Matt Jackson. Now Freyer goes up for three, and he rains it down and in. Quick catch, quick shot, and just like that, Grand Canyon goes up 5. 12-7 is the score at 14-15. West Virginia struggling on the offensive end. Mountaineers just 2 out of 8 from the floor. Here's Lamont West with it. To the outside right wing, here's Brandon Knapper. Knapper gets it to a curling Harler, kicks the ball back to Knapper, steps in, long three, too long, off the rim, rebound controlled by Laver. Outlets the ball into the hands of Drexel. Now taken by Carlos Johnson. Johnson top circle, driving, spinning into the lane, whistle, travel violation. We'll give it back to WVU. Third turnover against Grand Canyon. And Matthews asks out of the game. He's fatigued, and he'll be replaced by Jermaine Haley.
Just not enough offensive continuity by West Virginia early in this game. Better play by Grand Canyon.
Mountaineers have missed 7 of their 9 shots from the field. 5-point lead for Grand Canyon. West Virginia tries to answer here. Knapper with the ball. Double him and get it over to Lamont West. Doesn't pull the trigger. Now he will for 3. Off rim, no. 1 and out again goes West Virginia. Grand Canyon in transition. Drexel gets a screen, pulls up with that 3. In and out of the hole, no good. Rebound controlled. Foul call, West Virginia, after Finke, Tim Finke, came down with it. He'll call the foul against WVU, and they'll charge that one to West Virginia's Logan Round, his first, and the team's second.
Absolutely, Logan Round out of position, that low post area. He'll get beat every time if he assumes that position.
Roberts Blumberg's comes into the game now for Grand Canyon. He hasn't played since February 28th. On the inbound, out front, two Blumbergs. Kid out of Latvia. Over to Carlos Johnson. Watch him. He's dangerous. They double him, make him give the ball up. Now from the left baseline, jumper on rim and in. Score it for Trey Drexel. And it's a 7-point lead for Grand Canyon, 14-7. Grand Canyon has taken West Virginia out of its game, taking the crowd out of the game. 7 minutes gone by. Here's Haley driving. Haley pushing a shot up. That won't go. And the rebound cleared by Carlos Johnson on the attack. Johnson bounces right side. Drexel. Drexel down the lane, Drexel all the way in, layup won't go, and the rebound cleared by Lamont West, West Virginia in transition. Knapper now with the ball. Knapper up front, gets it to West. West spins toward the bucket, puts that one up off rim, no, and again, West Virginia can't get it to go down and in. Loose ball scrambled for, Route with a fantastic job, retaken by Drexel, now into the hands of Tim Finke, and back comes Grand Canyon. Leading at 14-7, now a whistle and a 10-second violation.
10-second violation.
Did not get the ball over. Fourth turnover against Grand Canyon.
Well, you know you have 2 point guards out here for West Virginia. Brandon Knapper and Jordan McCabe. McCabe is out of the game now. but you're not as good moving the basketball with Napper as you are with McCabe.
WV off to a woeful 2 of 12 shooting performance, just 17% from the field.
And Tony, they're not taking good shots. They're just not getting good shots.
Here's Napper again. Now you got Haley with the ball outside left. Knapp gets it between the two circles. Over on that left wing for West, drops it down inside. Culver spinning, turnaround on that baseline. Culver has got his first field goal. Now that ends a long drought by West Virginia. They had missed five in a row. 14-9, Grand Canyon with a five-point lead. Attacking the bucket, Milstead all the way to the hoop. Layup shot won't go into the hands of Lamont West. Transition West Virginia. West out to the left side. Harler with a three ball. Rimmed it out, no. Rebound tipped. Rebound controlled by Grand Canyon. They've got a run out. Into the front court comes Tim Finke, four-star recruit. Over to Milstead. Foul line extended left. Sends it to the right side. Blumberg's into the right side corner. Here's a push-up three. Off rim won't go. Napper comes up with it. After the miss there from the Antelopes, now Napper attacks. Napper gets bumped. Puts up a shot. He got it with the left hand.
Strong enough to get in there. Once he got the contact down the lane, Tony, he felt it, put the ball up to the rim.
Mountaineers now with consecutive field goals cut the lead of Grand Canyon down to 3, 14-11. 11:15 to go. Blumberg's with it. Dribble handoff out front. This is Milstead. Milstead attacks into that right side corner. Open three. Swish. Score it for Matt Jackson, his 10th of the year. It's a six-point Grand Canyon lead with 11 minutes to go, 17-11. Antelopes on top of the Mountaineers. Back on the other end. Here's Napper with the ball. Out front, left of the circle. Here's Culver. Makes a handoff to West. Now gets it to Haley. Jermaine attacks. Jermaine head fake. Puts one up on rim and in. His first two of the night. West Virginia's offense starting to get a little bit of a flicker here.
Yeah, you're right. That curl by Haley was big.
17-13. Antelopes lead it by four. 10.5 to go here. Out high, Milstead. Guarded by Napper. Takes the ball to the right side wing. Now bounces the ball inside, and Harler reaches from around to come over and knock that ball loose. And he'll be called on the foul as he came in and made contact with Trey Drexel. Harler's first foul. And that's West Virginia's 13th foul. Takes us to an immediate timeout. 10:24 to go, opening half. It's Grand Canyon 17, West Virginia 13. Coverage continues after this from U.S. Cellular. No hidden fees and national coverage in the middle of anywhere. Ten minutes and 24 seconds to go. Opening half. It is Grand Canyon on top of West Virginia by 4 points, 17-13. Tonight's game being brought to us in part by McDonald's. Download the McDonald's app for deals instantly. McDonald's, I'm loving it. So far, two lead changes, one tie. One of the key stats in this game is going to be rebound. Grand Canyon is just 2-9 this season when they are out-rebounded. And right now, the Antelopes are out-rebounding West Virginia by 6, 14-8 WVU. shooting just 31% to Grand Canyon's 43, and from three-point range, the Mountaineers just 1 of 5.
Well, Matt Jackson's been very big off the bench for Grand Canyon with 5 points to match Oscar Freyer's 5 points. It hasn't been Oscar Johnson early, I mean Carlos Johnson early in this game with only 2 points he has. Three guards on the floor now, Tony, for West Virginia.
Tim Finke inbounding underneath the Grand Canyon basket, gets it into the right side to his brother, Michael Finke, backs in against Emma Matthews, turnaround, 12-footer, airballed it, rebound cleared by Derek Culver. Now Brandon Knapper initiates the action into the front court. Out front between the two circles, Jordan McCabe. So West Virginia, as Jay said, three guards now, and they're playing with a small guard package with McCabe and Knapper. In the deep left corner, it goes to Brandon. He drops the ball inside to Culver. Culver confronted on that block. Double team, needs help. Throws it out to Harler. Now left wing. McCabe with a three ball, and he swishes it. Jordan McCabe is 41st three of the year. And the Mountaineers, after trailing by seven, closed it within one at 17-16.
Extra pass. That's what it was.
Yeah, exactly. Damari Milstead gets it down to the near side to Drexel, back out front. Michael Finke, three ball off right rim, no. Rebound corralled by Knapper. Now West Virginia with a chance to take the lead. Chase Harler on the far sideline right, drops the ball into Culver. Tipped out of bounds by Michael Finke and WVU. And have an inbound underneath its basket along the right baseline as Oscar Freyer returns, and they'll take out the guard, Damari Milstead.
Well, don't be in a hurry to get the lead, West Virginia. Play basketball.
Mountaineers break. And McCabe throws the ball in, but it's knocked out of bounds by Drexel. Hustler play by him. And it will stay with WV. They'll inbound across the far side of the floor, quarter court. Chase Harler, who's been shooting the ball better over the last six games, 44% from three. Inbounds to Jordan McCabe. 17-16, Grand Canyon leads by a point. Knapper out front, Harler sends it to the left side to McCabe, guarded by Freyer. Now McCabe starts to penetrate. Shot clock down eight in the deep left corner. Here's Emmett Matthews attacking, drops it in for Culver, makes the catch, shot rejected, back out to Matthews. 12-footer won't bank in for him, and the rebound is clear. Here comes Tim Finke, most highly touted player in the school's history as far as recruits go. Gives it to the near side wing, three up, off rim, no, off the miss from Blumberg's. Now McCabe, again, WVU, opportunity to take the lead. McCabe up front, floats the ball down inside, but the pass hits the rim, corralled by Matthews, to the rim, he goes, beautiful! Floating layup in for Emmett Matthews, and West Virginia leads 18-17. Boy, is he smooth. On to the other end, here's Drexel. Far side left, behind the screen, three ball up, off rim, no, a rebound corral by Derek Culver, outlets the ball to McCabe. Jordan's over midcourt, cross court, front court, left side, Knapper, stutter step, step back, jumper up in the air, good for two for Brandon Knapper. Timeout taken by Dan Marley, stopping the clock at 26 as Knapper hits his second field goal off the bench, and the Mountaineers lead it 20-17. Coverage continues of West Virginia and Grand Canyon in the opening round of the CBI after this from the West Virginia Lottery. You never know, it could happen to you. Please play responsibly. If I may.
What an honor and what a privilege it is to stand before you today as the head football coach at West Virginia University. I cannot be more excited to be your head football coach. We're going to work, we're going to compete, we're going to have fun. At the end of the day, we're going to make you proud. Let's go, Mountaineers.
Fans, please welcome the WVU dance team.
Check this out right here. Do wanna hate on us? Do need to ease on up? Do wanna act on gut, but do get shut like Flavin' Chuck? Chick say she ain't down, but chick backstage when we in town. She like men on drum. She wanna hit and run. Yeah, that's the speed. That's what we do. That's who we be.
B-L-A-C-K-E-Y-A-D-D to the E, then the A to the S. When we play, you shake it.
Shake it, shake it,
shake it, girl. Make sure you don't break it, girl.
Cause we gonna
turn it up. Come on, baby, just pump it.
Turn up the radio and blast.
on a 9-0 run, and now the Mountaineers are on top 20-17 with 8:26 to go in the half.
Well, Tony, only with two turnovers is West Virginia. On the other side, four turnovers for Grand Canyon. The problem in this game has been for West Virginia has been the rebounding, but they have come back so strong, 15-13. Grand Canyon still in the lead. Nice balance by Grand Canyon and by West Virginia in this game from their scorers.
Dan Marley used up the timeout, so possession, Grand Canyon. Guy you got to watch out for is the inbounder right here. This is Carlos Johnson. He's their leading scorer, and he has not got off yet, but you know it's only a matter of time before he starts to initiate offense. And here's Johnson with the ball out front, top circle. Got away with a travel. The crowd reacted. Now here's Johnson. He has the ball stripped away, and out of bounds it will go to Grand Canyon. And Huggs is livid that they missed a travel violation. And now he'll have a word with the official, Ron Taberski.
17 on the clock, Tony.
There's the inbound. Johnson throwing in, right side, catch, Frayer shooting. Three is up, and it is good. His second three, and Grand Canyon ties the game up at 20 apiece. Back comes Jordan McKay, walks the ball through the center jump circle, lobs it left of the circle out front, taken by Logan Rout. Now outside right to Emmett Matthews. Matthews got it by Michael Finke, curling up top. McKay lets a three flow, gets knocked down. Shot does not go down, but Napper comes up with a rebound, scissors it up. Won't go. Rebound slapped out of bounds by Labor, and it will stay with WVU.
Well, they're letting him play.
Here's the looks, number five, Matt Jackson.
Matt Jackson will check in now as Michael Finke goes to the bench. 20-20 is our score, 7:47 to go. McKay inbounds to Logan Rout. In the paint, he spins. Left-hand shot up. Good! Off the glass! And Raver has just picked up his second foul. Nice move by Logan Rout, his first field goal. Rout played well at the Big 12 tournament. He averaged 5 points and four rebounds. Now, those numbers don't send a shockwave down anyone's spine. However, here's a kid that averages 2-2 on the season. He averaged 5-4 in KC, and he scores the bucket there to put WVU up 22-20, and now they got to take Labor out of the game.
Yeah, they do, and a 47% shooter and Rout, but he went to the left and came back to the right shoulder.
And he sizzles in the free throw. Not bad, 47% shooter.
Nice little run. He gives you 4 or 5 minutes, Tony, and he gets you a bucket or a rebound.
Trey Drexel with the ball in the front court. Pounds the ball into the floor on the far left side of the floor. Now Carlos Johnson. Johnson driving the ball to the bucket. Layup shot won't go. Contact, whistle, offensive foul. Carlos Johnson picks up his second foul, and that is also a key part of the game plan for West Virginia to get both Labor and Johnson in foul trouble. And now Johnson has to take a seat with two fouls and 7:31 to go in the half. West Virginia with McCabe getting instruction from head coach Bob Huggins, brings the ball up over midcourt. Angles over to the left side, into the corner. Here's a jumper for three. Air ball, rebound corralled by the Antelopes. Bad miss there by Harler. Now into the hands of Drexel. Drexel out front with the ball. Gets a high ball screen from Blumbergs. Gives up his dribble. Needs some help. Sends it outside left. Blumbergs there. Now down low. Backing in. Pass underneath, easy slam dunk. Nice play as Roberts Blumbergs gets the easy dunk as they got inside of the Mountaineer defense. 23-22, West Virginia by a point. Lamont West heads to the scorer's table. McCabe now, front court. Sends it over to that left side to Harler. Harler has the ball knocked off of himself by Frayer, and West Virginia turns the ball over.
Not a good opportunity or play by Harler in the last 2 or 3 minutes.
Harler will come out of the game. Lamont West comes in. 23-22. West Virginia leads it by a single point. Into the front court comes Drexel, guarded by McCabe. Blumberg gets it out front between the two circles. Right side, watch it. Frayer has already hit two threes, lets another one go. This one's offline, no. Rebound gets volleyed around. Logan Rout controls, outlets the ball to McCabe. Antelopes are back defensively. McCabe in the front court, goes behind his legs, goes behind his back, penetrates, crosses over, needs some help. Now he's going to stop and pop, 16-footer, he hit it on the left side.
Yeah, Frayer that time turned away from him, and he just swung around, shot the jumper in.
Frayer limping as he comes back down the floor for Grand Canyon. West Virginia goes up 25-22. That was McCabe's fifth point. Here's Drexel with the ball just over midcourt, gets a high ball screen. drives left at the foul line, sends the ball left side to Blumberg, kicks the ball back out to Drexel. Drexel now attacks, pulls up, looking, sends it in the corner, and it's stolen away by Emmett Matthews. Matthews on a run out. Here's the freshman across the lane. Lamont West loses the ball momentarily, flips it back to Matthews. They'll reset now out to midcourt inside the center jump circle to Jordan McCabe.
Big offensive set right here.
Left wing, Napper. Through the hands, off the shoulder, out of bounds, off of Lamont West. That's the second time tonight that he has mishandled the ball. Unforced error. And at 5:39 to go here in the half, Derek Culver will re-enter off the turnover by WVU.
Boy, really a bad unforced turnover by Lamont West. Trying to shoot it before he ever caught it.
West Virginia now four turnovers. 25-22 Mountaineers. Drexel out high, guarded by Jordan McCabe. Enters the ball to Frayer. He's had a hot hand with eight. Middle of floor, Blumberg gets a touch. Now to the near side wing, Tim Finke. Gets the ball back over to Frayer. They give him the ball up, and now here's Blumberg's on the right side. Drexel open three, swished it.
Bad gamble by McCabe in that passing lane. It wasn't there.
Game tied, 25. Quickly into the front court comes Emmett Matthews on the left side wing. He doesn't pull the trigger on a three. Sends the ball back out front to Napper. Gets a screen from West. Gives up his dribble. Now drops the ball inside to Culver. He got pushed in the back and fouled at 5:03 to go in the half. They'll charge that to Matt Jackson, and that will be his first personal. Six team fouls now against the Antelopes as Jermaine Haley enters and Jordan McCabe will exit. Game tied at 25 apiece. Here's Napper on the inbound underneath the WV basket out front. Lamont West has it at the top of the circle. Culver was open, he didn't get it to him. Now sends it outside left, Napper gets it left to the lane. Here is Culver. Double team, sends the ball underneath the basket to West, and he gets manhandled and pushed from behind by Oscar Frayer. His first, seventh team foul. Lamont West will go to the line for a 1-1 with 4:53 left in the half.
We'll see what West does in that line. She's a 78% shooter, but has not had an early half here. A very good basketball.
It's a very nice pass by Culver to get the ball into the lane to Lamont West.
Yeah, good position that time.
And the first one is in. It's in play, and it's a 1-1. He'll get the bonus, his fourth point. Lamont has scored double figures in 9 of West Virginia's last 10 games, including 5 in a row. At 16 against Kansas on Friday night. West Virginia has taken the lead 26-25. Next one is up and it's in. 2-point Mountaineer lead. West Virginia has the lead, but shooting just 38% from the field. Antelopes are at 42%. Back come the Antelopes. Outside, far left. Here's penetration of the bucket. Spinning, looking underneath. Ball put up, and Culver rejects his shot. From Blumberg's, back comes Napper on the other end. Attacking, spinning, shooting. In and out, Wonko. Rebound controlled by Napper. Out to Lamont West. Here's a three. Off rim, no. And the rebound taken down by Grand Canyon. Pushing it up the floor comes Damari Milstead. Front court. Milstead at the foul line. Deals the ball left side. Frayer, another three. Off rim, no. Rebound controlled there by Blumberg's. And a new shot clock for the Antelopes. He backs in against Lamont West. Kicks the ball right side. Here's Matt Jackson. Three, he hit it.
He's got
his second of the game and only his 11th of the season. And on that, Grand Canyon takes a 1-point lead. On the other end, Haley bumped on the right baseline. That is number two against Oscar Frayer. So foul troubles building here for Grand Canyon. Three of the starters, Johnson, Labor, Frayer, each now with two as we go to a timeout. 3:57 remains, opening half. Grand Canyon on top by a point, 28-27. Coverage continues after this from Brick Street Insurance, your business, your people, your coverage.
At CBI Turning. All right, Mountaineers, it's time for the spin wheel. All right, fans, let's see those muscles.
It is Grand Canyon on top by a point, 28-27. 3:57 remains in our opening half. Get your Julia's original pepperoni roll at the nearest concession stand at the WVU Coliseum or order online at ChicoBakery.com. Antelopes have the one-point lead. However, West Virginia has become more active on the glass in a span of just about 7 minutes, almost 7 minutes. West Virginia went from trailing in the rebound department 14-6, and now the rebounds are even, 18 apiece.
Well, West Virginia's been unable to control on their defense. Matt Jackson and Oscar Freyer, because they have just added 16 points to their combined total of Grand Canyon's 28 points. They've been very, very good. They wait for the shot to come to them. They don't hurry. Both of them are talented shooters.
At the free throw line is Jermaine Haley. Mountaineers down by a point. Haley's free throw no good. In play, Matthews kicks it out to Haley. Now between the two circles to Brandon Napper. Chase Harler back out there for West Virginia. Napper sends the ball right of the circle. Here's Haley attacking, driving. He can't get it to fall, man. He's had some takes. They just are not going in early for Jermaine Haley as he slaps his hands together as he heads back down on defense. This is Milstead now on the other end for the black-clad Antelopes. Bounce pass, ball deflected on a backdoor cut attempt. Here comes Jermaine Haley. Haley attacking, left side. Emmett Matthews to the basket, and he is fouled on the play. He'll get two free throws. Took a left-hand layup shot with 3:24 to go here in the half. Foul call, Matt Jackson. That'll be his second. Another opportunity here to put West Virginia into a tie and then take the lead. This is two free throws. Let me correct myself on the foul call against Freyer earlier going to timeout. I had him down for two, one against Oscar Freyer. Here's Matthews now, the left-hander, puts the shot up, and it is in. Matthews now with six. Michael Finke returns to the floor.
West Virginia scoring points at the foul line, 6 of 8.
West Virginia's free throw shooting was key in its upset win over Texas Tech in the Big 12 Conference Tournament, 20 out of 22. And now we're going to get a violation here, and Brandon Napper went in the lane early, and that negates the second free throw attempt by Matthews, and we will stay tied at 28 apiece. Napper just lost his balance. Here comes Damari Milstead into the front court. Milstead, guarded by Napper, works right side. Napp gets knocked down, hugs upset on that. Milstead, far side left. Here is Finke penetrating down there. Culver guarding him. He backs in against Derek. Takes him into the paint. Sends the ball back out front. Milstead at the left of the circle. Shot clock 6. Milstead looking. Back out high. Taken by Matt Jackson. Inside layup shot won't go. Rebound tip. Michael Finke fouls it up and in. Work the offensive glass, and they go up 30-28 on the putback by Michael Finke. Napper now at the free throw line, steps back, and resets the offense. 2:40 left in this half. It's 30-28, Grand Canyon by two. Napper sends it right of the circle to Haley, looking for Culver, gets it to Culver right of the lane. They run a double at him. Culver bodies his way in on that baseline, out to the foul line to Matthews, underneath to Harler. Shot gets rejected out of there. And on the attack comes Tim Finke. Finke, right side wing, 3, off the line, no. Rebound taken up by Napper. Here comes West Virginia. Mountaineers down by 2. Napper penetrates, spins. Napper, layup shot, won't go. Culver there, follows it up and in to tie the game at 30.
Boy, what a way to run the court. Not a good play by Napper, 1 against 4, but the good hustle by Culver.
2 minutes to go, 30-30. Finke on the other end. Michael Finke misses on a 3. It rims in and out. Rebound down to Derek Culver, his 5th of the game. Now into the hands of Brandon Napper in the Mountaineer front court. Napper the ball through the top of the circle. Hands it over to Jermaine Haley. Haley
Takes the ball, maintains a dribble on the right side wing. Now gets it toward the right side corner to Culver. Again, they run a double at him. Culver steps through, stepped over the baseline. Turnover. WVU will give it back to Grand Canyon with 1:39 left in the half.
And once I said earlier, Grand Canyon doing a great job of forcing Culver out of that low post area along that baseline. That time committed a turnover.
Hugs has a word with Derek Culver as he comes to the Mountaineer bench. Hugs trying to help him out here to get rid of that ball in those double team situations. All right, game tied at 30, final 90 seconds. With the ball out front, Matt Jackson, and he throws it away. Steal. Here comes Jordan McCabe. McCabe, bounce pass right side. Haley, layup. Got it. West Virginia goes up. Transition off the turnover, 32-30. Haley's fourth point. Back comes Damari Milstead. 1:15 left in the half. Milstead attacks, puts a shot up. Rejected into the stands by Logan Rout. Rout with a big block on help side defense. And the Antelopes will maintain possession, inbounding underneath their basket along that right baseline. Tim Finke inbounds to his brother Michael, and his pass, right side, taking it down the corner. Here's a layup shot and a slam dunk put down by Tim Finke. Ties the game up at 32 apiece. Less than a minute to go now in our opening half. McCabe gets a screen, crosses over, sends it left side to Haley. Jermaine drops the ball inside to Logan Rout. Backs in, spins. Here's that left-hand hook on rim. Won't go. Rebound. Foul call against West Virginia. And they'll charge that to Logan Rout. And that's 16 fouls against the Mountaineers. Rout picks up his second.
Team foul number five.
32 apiece. 46 seconds to go.
His body was out of control that time once he made that move.
Comes Damari Milstead. He averages 10 a game, has not scored yet this evening. Over the 10-second line, gets a high screen. Milstead attacks, sends it right side. Here's an open three, missed. Weak side rebound cleared by Jermaine Haley. Haley on the attack, into the front court. Haley into the lane, layup shot. He got it to go for a 6-point. Mountaineers lead by two, 34-32, 28 seconds to go, and Dan Marley tells his team, play it for the last shot. Game clock, shot clock, almost identical. Here's Milstead with the ball out high. Bumped by McCabe. Don't want to get a foul out there. West Virginia's already got 16 fouls. Now Milstead starts. Gives the ball out to Michael Finke. Fakes that three. Dribble handoff. Ball gets deflected. Harler after it. Harler on the floor. Harler throws it to Rout. Rout to Haley. Haley. Dunk! What a play! To end the first half. Harler with the hustle. Handed up to Haley. And Haley ripped her down as the horn sounded with an emphatic slam dunk. Halftime at the Coliseum. West Virginia into the locker room, leading it 36-32. A spectacular play. That was Harler to Rout to Haley, and he dunked it at the buzzer. Mountaineers go into the locker room with their largest lead of the first half. Up by four. Haley gets hot late with eight. Back after this, WV Medicine, leading healthcare here and everywhere.
At WV.
Length of the floor and take a shot to win free pizza for 1 year. Tonight's first contestant is Jace. Good luck. Nice try. Alex is our second contestant tonight. Good luck. Nice job! That's a year of free Papa John's pizza for Alex. Contestant number three is Josiah. Good luck. Nice try. That's the Papa John's pizza final second shootout. Fans, how about a warm welcome for tonight's halftime entertainment provided by the Hoops Dreams Youth Basketball Team.
We're
is, what it does, what it is, what it isn't. Looking for a better way to get up out of bed instead of getting on the internet and checking a new hit. Me get up, first shot, come strut walking. A little bit of humble, a little bit of cautious. Somewhere between like Rocky and Cosby's for the game. Nope, nope, y'all can't copy yet. Bad moonwalking, and this here is our party. My posse's been on Broadway, and we did it all way. Chrome music, I shed my skin and put my bones into everything I record to it. And yeah, I'm on. Let that stage light go and shine on down. Got that Bob Barker suit game and Plinko in my style. Money, stay on my craft and stick around for those pounds. But I do that to pass the torch and put on for my town. Trust me, on my I-N-D-E-P-E-N-D-E-N-T. Hustling, chasing dreams since I was 14 with the four-track busting. Halfway across that city with the back-back-back-back-question. Labels out here, now they can't tell me nothing. We give that to the people, spread it across the country. Labels out here, now they can't tell me nothing. We give it to the people, spread it across the country.
Can we go back? This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't hold us.
Can we go back?
Kick it, thank you, yeah, I'm so, so grateful. I grew up really wanting gold fronts, but that's what you get when Wu-Tang raised you. Y'all can't stop me, go hard like I got an 808 in my heartbeat. And I'm eating at the beat like it gave a little speed to a great white shark on shark. We raw, time to go off, I'm gone. Deuces, goodbye, I got a world to see. And my girl, she wanna see Rome. Caesar make you a believer, nah, I never ever did it for a throne. That validation comes from giving it back to the people. Now, sing this song and it goes like, raise those hands, this is our party. We came here to live life like nobody was watching. I got my city right behind me. If I fall, they got me. Learn from that failure, gain humility, and then we keep marching.
Can we go back? This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't. The moment, tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't hold us. Let's go back. This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't hold us.
Giving me is fiction. I'm a sorry sucker, and this happens all the time. I find out that everybody talks, everybody talks, everybody talks. It started with a whisper, and that was when I kissed her. And then she made my lips hurt. I could hear the chit chat. The wind. Words got in
picture. Hey, sugar, what you gotta say? It started with a whisper.
Get advice, ask for advice, get money twice. I'm from the dirty, but that Chico nice. Y'all call it a moment, I call it life.
One day while the light is glowing, I'll be in my castle golden. But until the gates are open, I just wanna feel this moment. I just wanna feel this moment. Ooh, I just wanna feel this moment.
30 seconds, 30 seconds left to play.
Miss Worldwide, Christina Aguilera. Oye, mamita, dale, que la cosa está rica.
Fans, how about a nice round of applause for the Hoops Dreams youth basketball team.
Always, it was O's and O's, they counted always, real fat all day. Now baby, we can parlay, oh baby, we can party. She read books, especially about red rooms and
fans, a reminder that beer sales will end at the conclusion of halftime. Don't forget to stop by the WBU Team Shop located at the Blue Gate to pick up tonight's gear of the game. Tonight's gear of the game is the WBU baseball hat. Roman makes men's health easy, convenient, and discreet. From online diagnosis by a U.S. licensed physician to prescription medication delivered to your door, always with free two-day shipping. Visit GetRoman.com/CBI to learn more and start your free online visit. Fans, turn your attention to the video board for tonight's first half highlights.
With all the ice on in the booth. At the gate outside, when they pull up, they give me loose. Yeah, jump out, boys, that's Nike boys hopping our coast, coast. Way too big, when we pull up, give me the loot.
Give me the loot.
Was off the Remy, had up at post. Had to hit my old town.
Let's bring on the Mountaineer.
Too deep,
too formal, y'all know I don't follow suit. Stacy Dash, most of these girls ain't got a clue. All of these ladies, I made off records I produce. I might take all my exes and put them all in a group. Hit my essays, I need the booch. About to turn this function into Bonnaroo. Told her I've been, you coming too. In the 30, treat me like I'm Uncle Luke. Slot the top off, it's just a roof. She said, where we going? I set the moon. We ain't even make it to the room. She thought it was the ocean, it's just a pool. Now I gotta open, it's just a goose. Who put this together? I'm the glue.
So and said,
shorty face, Tommy out the blue.
So and said, so and said, motherfucker, so and said.
Don't play with the weak.
Yeah! Astro. Yeah. Hey. She's in love with who I am. Back in high school, I used to bust it to the dance. Now I hit the FBO with duffels in my hands. I did half a Xan, 13 hours till I land. Had me out like a light, ay, like a light, ay, like a light, ay. Slept through the flight, ay, not for the night, ay. 767, man, this shit got double bedroom, man. I still got scores to settle, man. I crept down the block, made a right, yeah. Cut the lights, yeah. Pay the price, yeah. Think it's sweet, it's on sight, yeah. Nothing nice, yeah. Vegas in my eyes, Jesus Christ, yeah. Checks over stripes, yeah. That's what I like, yeah. That's what we like, yeah. Lost my respect, yeah. You not a threat. When I shoot my shot, that sh wetty like on Shex. Shots that I took, wet like on Book, wet like on Lizzie. I be spinning valley circle blocks till I'm busy. Like, where is he? No one seen him. I'm tryna clean him. She's in love with who I am. Back in high school, I used to bust it to the dance. Now I hit the FBO with duffels in my hands. Woo. I did half a Xan, 13 hours till I land. Had me out like a light,
like a light, like a light.
Down in your hometown, transforming lives with patient care, research, and innovation. Visit WVUmedicine.org.
Tony, I made a mistake on Rob with Rob on the first half. I had the bench points, West Virginia 15-7. Let's reverse that. Grand Canyon had 15 points off the bench, mainly led by Matt Jackson. But how about Brandon Napper with 6 rebounds to lead the Mountaineers in the first half rebound?
Yeah, how about that? I don't think anyone had that coming into the game, that West Virginia's guard Brandon Napper would have 6 boards. He does, going along with 4 points. Derek Culver, 5 points and 5 rebounds so far. 6 points, 3 boards, Emmett Matthews. 5 points, 3 rebounds for Lamont West, but he did not shoot it well. 1 of 6 overall, 1 of 4 from 3. Jordan McCabe, 5 points, a couple of rebounds, and assist and a steal in 12 minutes. Jermaine Haley got hot late, 8 points. Emphatic dunk at the end of the first half, put West Virginia up by 4. Second half underway. On the attack comes Damari Milstead. Out high to Carlos Johnson. Slowed in that first half by fouls, and now off ball, we're going to get a whistle and a foul call against Alessandro Labor with an elbow. And they're starting big, has just picked up his third foul, 8 seconds into this second half, and Dan Marley's got a decision to make. He's a big scorer for them. He averages 13 points per game. Into the front court. This is McCabe. Gets the ball to Haley. Haley on the attack. Scoops the layup shot up and in. Won't go. Rebound volley. Culver in the paint. Lays it up. Can't get that to fall. Another opportunity. Culver again. Fights. Shoots. Won't go. Rebound tipped out of bounds. And it will go to WVU. 3 cracks at it. And West Virginia unable to put it in, but the Mountaineers maintain possession. McCabe. Underneath the basket, baseline left, lobs it into Culver, makes the catch, drop step, layup shot, won't go, gets kicked back out to McCabe, and now they'll reset the offense up. With 4 point blank shots, West Virginia cannot get it to go. McCabe now, outside left of the circle to Culver. Culver with that handoff. Here's West, sets those feet, 1 of 6 in the first half, 1 of 7 in the second half. Rebound taken out of there by Freyer. Bob Huggins looks down in dejection after the miss by West. 4 point West Virginia lead. Milstead deals that ball up top. Michael Finke gets it over to Freyer. Freyer had a good first half with eight. Now Laver against Culver on that baseline. Backs him in. Takes him into the bank. Puts that shoulder down, and they're going to call a whistle and a foul. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, that was bad. Yeah,
that's ridiculous. Bad. My man is in there.
Oh, whistle on Derek Culver.
And just that's swinging to try to get contact, and they call that foul. That's garbage.
That's a no foul because the battle in there, you let them go. Play on.
Laver, 74% free throw shooter. Culver's picked up his second foul. That's ridiculous. Free throw up and in. 36-33. West Virginia's lead is three. Exactly right. This is a no call right there.
Yeah.
Next one. Got them both. And that cuts the Mountaineer lead down to two, 36-34. Now Jordan McCabe crosses over the 10-second line, guarded by Milstead. On a bounce, outside left, taken by Haley. Haley delivers that ball to Emma Matthews. Matthews steps back out between the circles. Over on that right side wing to Jermaine Haley. And near the right corner area here, Lamont West. West dribbles that ball back to the near side wing, gets the ball to Culver, shot clock seven. Culver double team, tries to get down the baseline. They'll call a blocking foul against Michael Finke. That'll become his second. Shot clock had gone down to 6 seconds. West Virginia will inbound it underneath on the common foul.
Now get 20 seconds.
McCabe throws in. Boy, Lamont West at some points needs to hit a shot here, Jay. And here McCabe's going to try one off right side rim. No. And the rebound controlled by Labor. 36-34. WVU leads by two. Minute and 45 gone by here in our second half. Michael Finke, their big man out front, looks down inside. Alley-oop lob, tipped, controlled. Off the miss from Freyer. 5-on-4 on the other end. Here's McCabe. Gets it to Matthews. Matthews attacks underneath. Culver with a slam dunk.
He's tired of going under the basket. He went over top.
West Virginia retakes a four-point lead. 38-34. 2 minutes, 10 seconds gone. Second half in the front court. This is Carlos Johnson. Johnson guarded by Haley. Going to stop, pop, three ball online. No, off the back of the backboard, over the backboard, out of play. WVU will get it.
Well, Carlos Johnson struggling here in the first half to begin the second half, too.
Emmett Matthews inbounds to Jordan McCabe. Mountaineers leading it 38-34. West Virginia just one of seven from the field here in the first 2.5 minutes. McCabe on a pass, couldn't get it. Milstead steals it. Milstead to the bucket. Layup shot up and good off the turnover. That's West Virginia's lead is cut to two, 38-36. McCabe now resets the offense for WVU in the front court between the two circles. Barks out instructions. Man-to-man defense by Grand Canyon. McCabe hands the ball off out front to Haley. Haley attacks. Sends the ball out to Lamont West. Going to try another three ball. He got that one.
He's not afraid, Tony. He shoots two misses.
And for his mental state of mind, Jay, he really needed one to go down there. And that puts West Virginia up by 5, 41-36. Milstead on the other end behind a screen. He'll let a three ball fly, and he swished it in.
3-point shot.
Damari Milstead now with five here in the half after going scoreless in the opening half. Two-point West Virginia lead, 41-39. 16-35 and ticking. Here's McCabe poking after him as Milstead. McCabe drops the ball down inside. It's a steal taken by Laver on the outlet. Attacking. Here's Carlos Johnson in the paint. Layup good, and they're going to wave it off, call a floor foul before the shot. And that'll be an inbound for Grand Canyon, and they're going to put the foul call against Jordan McCabe. Jordan's going to come out of the game. Brandon Knapper will replace him.
Yeah, I think McCabe just too soft to pass, trying to go inside. Sometimes you could force your way in there.
Johnson will be the inbounder. 41-39 is the score. WVU leads by two. Get that ball. Here's Laver against Culver. He's got those two fouls. He's backing him in, backing him in, backing him in. They double him up. He kicks the ball out. Left corner, open three. Shot off rim, won't go. Rebound tipped and scaled down by Lamont West. Into the front court comes Knapper. Knapper, top circled. Lamont West. West looking down inside for Culver. Jab steps, takes that ball in there, gets some contact, bounces the ball back out front. Now a long jumper up, won't go off the back iron. Rebound, Culver is fouled at 16:01. And to whom will the foul be called? That's Carlos Johnson's third. Carlos Johnson with his third foul at 16:01. That's Grand Canyon's leading scorer.
You know, Tony, when you don't look inside enough, and that's what West Virginia, all their view and their eyes are on the perimeter. Go inside the Culver.
Knapper on the inbound. Lobs it out front to Haley. 4 minutes gone in our second half. They get it to Culver. Culver a double team. Bounces the ball inside. Matthews hammered to the floor. And that is Carlos Johnson again at 15:56. Carlos Johnson, Grand Canyon's leading scorer, has picked up another foul. That's number four. That is a huge, huge sequence right there. We go to a media timeout. Free throws coming up for Emmett Matthews when we return with West Virginia on top, 41-39 with 15:56 left. Back after this from McDonald's. Download the McDonald's app for deals instantly. I'm loving it.
WVU Medicine Children's. Purchase your tickets today at WVUgame.com.
Source, individual and family health insurance that has you covered with kindness.
It's West Virginia by 2, 41-39 over Grand Canyon with 15:56 to go in this opening round game of the College Basketball Invitational. Congratulations to our book exchange trivia winner. It is David Long of Buchanan. He correctly told us that the significance of West Virginia's victory over its last WAC opponent, UMKC, was that it was West Virginia's, Bob Huggins' 800th career win. So congratulations, David gets a $25 gift card. Grand Canyon's outscored WVU 7-5 here in the second half. Mountaineers lead by two. Emmett Matthews will go to the free throw line as play resumes and he'll have two shots.
Well, the rebounding has certainly changed. West Virginia more aggressive on the board now, Emmett, a plus five at 30-25.
Emmett, 2 of 2. At the line so far tonight. And the young man out of Tacoma puts it up and in. Emmett averaging 11 points and 7 rebounds over the last 6 games of the season to this point. Top 200 recruit, originally signed at the University of Connecticut, then with the coaching change came to WVU, and he is going to be a very, very good player in this program. He makes both of those, and West Virginia goes up by 4, 43-39.
More points by him, more minutes by Emmett Matthews, gave more confidence to Emmett Matthews.
There's Damari Milstead initiating offense to the near side wing to Drexel. Drexel negates a screen, drives it down toward the lane, kicks pass out right side, and a loose ball taken by Milstead. Hugs wanted a travel call on that. They reset their offense, 10 on the shot clock. Milstead going to try a three. That one up and in for Damari Milstead, who has scored 8 here in the second half after going scoreless in the first half. And the Mountaineer lead again cut to just 2 points, 43-41. Knapper now runs the show for WVU. Andrew Gordon to the bucket. Gets knocked down. Whistle, travel violation.
Well, you know when Gordon comes into the game, something's going to happen. It's either going to be good or it's going to be real bad. And that was just an unforced turnover.
Ridiculous. 43-41 on his part. Yeah, just passed the ball. Out high, this is Milstead, who's had the hot hand. He's confronted by Gordon. Out front, here's a long jumper for three. Off back iron, off the miss from Laver. Loose ball, though, controlled by Grand Canyon. They drop it in for Laver, and an easy slam dunk ties the game at 43. Laver scores his sixth point. Tied at 43 apiece. Here's Napper, outside left, taken by Jermaine Haley. Haley, back between the circles to Napper. Freshman looks, sends it left side wing, Lamont West. West now left of the lane. Here's Gordon backing in. Labor's got three fouls. Gordon tries to get contact, kicks the ball through. It gets deflected out of bounds, stays with West Virginia with 6 seconds on the shot clock. And Culver Jordan will re-enter McCabe for the Mountaineers, along with Jordan McCabe. And Andrew Gordon will take a seat along with Brandon Napper.
Yeah, couldn't happen a better time to get Culver in the game.
Just six on the shot clock. West Virginia needs to be cognizant of that. Game's tied at 43. Haley holds, gets it into Lamont West. Clock's down to four. At three, steps back, pushes up that jumper. He hit a three as the clock was about to expire. 11 for West. WVU retakes the lead, 46-43.
They better guard Milstead.
Yep, he's got 11 here in the half. Gets the ball to Laver. Backdoor cutting. Again, Haley there to break that up. Second time he's done it today. Haley on the other end. Haley into the lane. Floating lamp shot won't go. Rebound kept alive by Matthews. And is controlled by the Antelopes. On the outlet, into the hands of Milstead. Far court. Into the front court on the far sideline. Gets a screen. McCabe goes under it. Milstead kicks that ball. Open jumper. Baseline up. And it won't go as the rebound is missed off the shot from Jackson. Here's WVU with a three-point lead, 46-43. McCabe gets a high screen. Over to Lamont West, jab steps, gives the ball back out front. Taken there by Jordan McCabe, man-to-man defense by Grand Canyon. Haley has it. Foul line extended left to Emmett Matthews. Haley runs through. Culver gets it to the top of the circle. Clock at 10, off-ball foul call. And they're going to charge that one against Oscar Freyer. Freyer picks up the personal. That is his second. At 13:26 to go, Michael Finke will come on now as Alessandro Laver will take a seat.
They have five team fouls on Grand Canyon.
There's McCabe inbounding underneath the WVU basket on that right baseline. Lobs it front of the Mountaineer bench to Haley, between the two circles to West. Lamont couldn't get it to a cutting McCabe. Now it goes near side wing to Haley. Now McCabe pops back out and gets it out front. Shot clock's already down to 10. McCabe calls for a screen, gets it from Culver. He's at the top of the circle. Sends the ball right side. Here's Haley, four on the clock, three on the clock. Gets it to McCabe, got to get a shot off. He launches that off rim, no. Rebound taken out of there by Freyer, and back comes Grand Canyon. 7 minutes gone in the second half. West Virginia with a three-point lead, 46-43. Milstead, who's had the hot hand, penetrates into the lane. Floating layup shot in and around and in for Milstead. He's up to 10 points here. It's a one-point West Virginia lead, 46-45. McCabe on the other end, out front, deals the ball left side to Haley. Haley now back to McCabe. Haley gets a return, sends it to the right side wing. Here's Lamont West, jab steps, step back. So he puts a three up, it rims out, no, and the rebound is cleared by Michael Finke. Now a one-point West Virginia lead as Damari Milstead brings the ball into the front court. Logan Rout goes to the scorer's table. Here's Freyer with it. He can score, and he's going to pull the trigger, and he'll hit a two-pointer from out front left of the circle for his 10th point, and Grand Canyon takes a one-point lead, 47-46, and now the crowd up, trying to encourage the Mountaineers. WVU has gone over 2 minutes without a point, 47-46. Antelopes, we're inside of 12 minutes left in this game. Who is it going to be for WVU? McCabe off the ball. Matthews has it out front, get it back over to McCabe. McCabe going to stop, going to pop. That three is an air ball, but Matthews there lays it up, missed it. Rebound Haley. He scores and is fouled on the play. So a horrible three from McCabe ultimately leads to a basket for West Virginia as the Mountaineers retake the lead, 48-47, 11:43 to go. Free throws for WVU when we return after this from WVU Medicine, leading healthcare here and everywhere.
Tournament information, including roster cards, ticket information, post-game wrap-ups, and statistics. That's collegebasketballinvitational.com. Fans, get on your feet for the Coliseum Dance Camp.
Mr. Worldwide to infinity. You know the roof on fire. We gon' boogie, oogie, oogie, jiggle, wiggle, and dance. Like the roof on fire. We gon' drink drinks and take shots until we fall out. Like the roof on fire. Now, baby, get my booty naked, take off all your clothes and light the roof on fire. Tell him, baby, 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 I'm on fire. I tell her, baby, 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 I'm a fireball. On fire, he no lie. Well, y'all slipping, he's running the game. Now, big bang boogie, get that kitty little noogie in a nice, nice little shave. I gave Susie a little pat up on the booty, and she turned around and said, walk this way.
I was born in a plane. Mama said that every word was on my name. I'm the best you've ever had. If you think I'm burning out, I never am.
Shooting the ball well at all in this game. Total for the night, 35% on 18 out of 52, and it's worse in the second half. The Mountaineers are 4 out of 16, 25%. On the other side, Grand Canyon at 43% for the game. They're shooting it at 60% in the second half, largely in part to the play of Damari Milstead, who has rung it up here, Jay, for 9 points.
The difference has been the three-point shooting today. 7 three-pointers by Grand Canyon has made a difference for them. They're getting shots, and Milstead, the point guard, has really directed a fine offense out here for Grand Canyon.
Jermaine Haley, 0 of 1 at the free throw line, will try to finish a three-point play. And the Mountaineers with that one-point lead. Here's Haley. Shot is up, and he swishes it in. And Jermaine now with 11 points. Ironically, this is the third time Jermaine Haley has played Grand Canyon. He played him twice when he was at New Mexico State. On the attack, they look down inside. Michael Finke makes the catch, puts up the shot, and he missed it. And the rebound cleared by Logan Routh. Outlets the ball to Jordan McCabe. Mountaineers 49, Grand Canyon 47. Into the front court. Here's Chase Harler. Pitches the ball back out front, taken there by Jordan McCabe between the two circles, being guarded by Milstead. McKay barks out instruction, gets it to Haley, who cut across the lane left to right. Haley backing in on the block, puts up a layup shot in and out of the hole. It won't go. He got a good look. And in transition, ball stolen momentarily, taken by McCabe. McCabe runs it down the other end. McCabe in the front court. Here's Jordan McCabe. Left side corner, open three, Lamont West. He missed it, and the rebound controlled by Grand Canyon. It went in and out. In transition, back comes Tim Finke. Leaves the ball over for Drexel. Drexel behind a screen, guarded by Chase Harler out front. 10:45 to go in the game. Mountaineers lead by 2, 49-47. Now penetration. Drexel pulls up 17-footer baseline left, swishes it in there. Basket Drexel with his 7 point smooth shooter ties the game at 49 apiece. 10:35 and counting. Jordan McCabe dribble jogs through the center jump circle. Milstead there waiting on him. McCabe bounces the ball errantly. A foul called on a hold. Intended for Logan Rout. And they're going to charge that one.
Small whistle, number 43.
That's Michael Finke's third. So
third.
Now you've got three Grand Canyon players with three fouls, and Carlos Johnson with four, and Logan Rout goes to the free throw line. That was the seventh team foul against the Antelopes with 10:24 to go. Logan Rout, one out of one at the line tonight. This will be the front end of a 1-1.
Well, 47% shooters we mentioned.
Pushes the shot up, and that one's in and out. A line drive that shot up, and the game stays tied at 49 apiece. Now Milstead, front court. Over to Trey Drexel. Drexel yo-yos that ball, gives up that dribble, needs some help. And still needing some help, and finally he gets it to the right side, and here's a layup shot, no good. Off the miss, Haley in transition, pushing it up the floor. Haley cuts through the free throw line, and now he'll set the offense up for the Mountaineers. And now we're going to get Lamont West pushing off against Finke, and West picks up his first and the third team foul of the second half. An empty possession for WVU, and Emmett Matthews will be summoned into the game, and Lamont West will come out.
Well, you really, when you don't have any depth, and West just came over and set a screen and committed a foul.
All right, game tied at 49 apiece, 9:54 to go here, and Grand Canyon will have the opportunity to take the lead. Here's Milstead out front, into the hands now of Matt Jackson. Jackson hands that ball off to Tim Finke, backdoor cutting, they get it into the lane, and here's a layup shot up and good, score it for Trey Drexel, and Grand Canyon takes a 51-49 lead, 9.5 to go. Back comes McCabe. West Virginia shooting just 22% in the second half, 4 of 18. Here's a cut to the basket. McCabe, scoop layup shot, won't go. Rout follows it up and in. Big play by Logan Rout. 51 apiece, 9:15 to go. Mountaineers on the defensive end. Milstead, way up front left. Calls for a ball screen from Finke. McCabe goes under it. Now Milstead attacks, pulls up, 15-footer. He airballed it, and the loose ball taken by the freshman Matthews. Outlets the ball to McCabe. WVU, chance to take the lead. Game tied 51. Here's McCabe. McCabe out front. Sends the ball to Harler. Harler with a three ball. Swish! From the right side win. His first points of the night. It's West Virginia 54-51. 8:45 to go. Back comes Grand Canyon. Michael Finke with the ball. Guarded by Logan Rout out front. Jackson gets it out front. Dribbles across the top of the circle. Backdoor cut pass. Back out to Matt Jackson. Sets his feet. Gets the ball to the right side wing. Milstead three. Off rim, no. Rebound. Foul against Grand Canyon. Chase Harler was pushed down by Trey Drexel, and Harler will walk to the other end, and he will have a 1-1 with 8:28 to go with the Mountaineers on top by three.
Good to have Harler there, 71% shooter, Tony, but he doesn't get the line very often.
Roberts Blumbergs will come in. Jackson will go to the bench. Also re-entering is Alessandro Laver, as Chase Harler steps up.
12 out of 17 this year.
And he'll get a bonus. That's so big. Harler hit that three on West Virginia's last possession to put him up by three. Now makes the free throw. His fourth point puts them up by four. 55-51 WVU.
Need a good guard at the other end. That's what you have to do.
Harler makes them both.
Nice set by Chase. Yep.
A little pressure here by McCabe in the backcourt. Advancing the ball. Drexel. Through the center, jump circle. Guarded tightly by McCabe. Drexel looking for Frayer, can't get it to him. Drexel still out front, wide left. 15 shot clock. Has his back to the basket. Now they double him up. Ball gets knocked loose over to the left side corner. Here's Frayer for a three. He missed it. Rebound taken off the weak side by Harler. Chase pushes up the floor into the front court. Here's Haley. Haley to the bucket. Layup. Good. By Jermaine Haley.
Nice run set up by Harler.
West Virginia goes up 58-51. Is Dan Molley going to take a timeout? Nope. They're going to play on in the front court. Backing in is Drexel against McCabe. Gives up his dribble. Left side to Matt Jackson. Left of the lane. Make that Laver. Laver backs in against Emma Matthews. Double team. Fall away on the baseline. Up and in for Alessandro Laver. 58-53. Haley on the other end to the bucket. Layup good! He did it again. Jermaine Haley down the left side of the lane. Answers. Putting West Virginia up by seven. 60-53. 7:20 to go. Into the front court. This is Drexel with the ball. On the far side right. At the free throw line. Gives the ball up to Frayer. Frayer penetrates, pulls up at the foul line. Jumper won't go. Rebound out of bounds to WVU with 7:12 to go.
Nice little run here as we go to a timeout.
West Virginia has made four straight buckets, keyed by Chase Harler and Jermaine Haley. WVU has its largest lead, up seven, 7:12 to go. It's 60-53 Mountaineers. We return after this from Subway, the official training restaurants of athletes everywhere.
Nothing in the fourth inning. He blasted it all the way back to Bluefield. Here's your chance to be part of Mountaineer Baseball at Monongahela County Ballpark. Single game tickets are on sale now. Reserve your seats today at WVUGame.com or by calling 1-800-WVUGAME. It's now time for this Building Mountaineer Basketball Moment presented by Dan Ryan Builders. It was the 2008 Big East Tournament quarterfinals where junior forward Joe Alexander would put another exclamation point on his Mountaineer career. Alexander had several brilliant moments to score 34 points in an upset of Jim Calhoun's 15th-ranked UConn Huskies, including this one in the game's final seconds.
The man wide open, it's Alexander. Robinson.
Alexander carried WVU to the NCAA Sweet 16 before leaving for the NBA draft.
Is on a run. The Mountaineers have made four straight field goals after struggling for much of this game from the field, and WVU now owns a 7-point lead, 60-53, over the Antelopes of Grand Canyon University. Tonight's game being brought to us in part by CareSource. They provide our act of heart moment, and you'd have to give that right now to Jermaine Haley with consecutive layups. CareSource, individual and family health insurance that has you covered with kindness.
You know what, Tony? Culver's now coming back in the game, and West Virginia has to be very, very careful here with this lead. You don't want to stop your offense. It's got a lot of motion in it. Stop and try to throw the ball every time to Culver. Work your offense. Go through him. Remember, Derek Culver is better off the second shot than he is the first.
Culver's numbers tonight, 7 points, 8 rebounds. Derek enters in the season with 10 double-doubles in his 24 games on the season.
Yeah, you mentioned Jermaine Haley. I think Jermaine Haley's a pro if he just would get in and work in that gym, boy. He's got size, everything.
Here comes Jordan McCabe bringing the ball into the front court. Trey Drexel waiting on him. They go inside the free throw circle, taken by Chase Harler. He gives a look inside. Haley makes the catch. Haley puts up a shot off the glass over Freyer. He scores again. Haley with 17, and West Virginia goes up by 9, 62-53. Back on the other end, Blumberg's with the ball. Out to Drexel, kick pass, right side corner. Now Finke, jumper up, he airballed it. Tim Finke missed, rebound cleared by Haley. Haley into the front court. Haley stops at the top of the circle. Out to McCabe, NBA left side three, off rim no. Rebound tip, controlled by the Antelopes. In transition, a whistle, and a foul call! Beautiful job at midcourt by Jordan McCabe to take a charge against Tim Finke, who took the outlet and started up the floor. And the littlest guy on the court, Jordan McCabe, was there, set his feet, and takes the charge.
Never saw him, Tony. Never saw him. Finke never saw him coming up the floor because Finke was in the mood to score at the other end.
62-53, West Virginia with the possession and the 9-point lead, 6:28 to go.
I'm featuring Haley again.
Here's McCabe out front with the ball. Gets it to the top of the circle to Chase Harler. Gets it in the paint to a cutting Haley. Haley sends the ball back to Emmett Matthews. He'll step for a three. No good. Rebound out of bounds. And they're going to say it goes to Grand Canyon. It looks like it's a missed call.
Yep.
And they're going to keep it with Grand Canyon possession. Hugs wanted one official to look to the other for help after that miss by Emmett Matthews. And here's on the other end. Ball in play. West Virginia up by 9. Here's Milstead. Gets a screen. Top of the circle. Gives the ball back. Left side. Laver penetrates against Culver. Pulls up on the left block. Fall away 13-footer. He airballed it. Loose ball taken out by Emmett Matthews. Down the floor. McCabe finds Haley. Haley to bucket. Layup! Good! And the foul as it took a lap around the rim. Haley is absolutely on fire. Jermaine Haley has scored 11 points in the second half, 19 in the game. He puts West Virginia up by double figures for the first time tonight, 64-53. And Haley will have a chance at another three-point play. The foul call goes against Carlos Johnson, and the leading scorer for the Antelopes is out of the game with five at 5:53 to go. And Johnson, who averaged 25 points in the WAC tournament, held to just 2 points here tonight in foul trouble all night long. Haley steps up. One out of two tonight. And the junior from Vancouver makes the shot. He's got a 20-point night.
What did he have first half?
Eight.
Okay, he's 12 points second half, big.
65-53, West Virginia leads it by 12. Still a lot of time, 5:45 to go. Got to be careful here. This team can make threes. Out high with it is Drexel on the far side wing. He's going to gun up an NBA three on rim, out. Rebound down to Derek Culver. That's his ninth of the night. Outlet in transition. Matthews sends the ball up top to Jordan McCabe. McCabe now needs to be judicious with a good possession here with 5:25 to go in the game. Shot clock shows 17. McCabe dribbles out front. Again, they go inside that free throw circle to Harler. He's a good passer from there. Chase sends it through the hands of Derek Culver. Off the backboard, it deflected. Loose ball taken by Grand Canyon. Back they come. Again, they're down a dozen, 65-53. Drexel poked after by Culver, pushes him out a little bit toward midcourt. Now Drexel on the attack, and Culver, in total frustration, commits the foul, his second, make it his third, fourth team foul against WVU.
You're right, Tony. You have to watch what you're doing here. Although you're sitting on a 12-point lead, doesn't mean anything. This Grand Canyon club knows how to play the game, and they know where their shooters are.
On the inbound, into the hands of Milstead. He's had the hot hand here. Milstead attacks all the way to the rim. Layup shot won't go. Rebound taken by Culver. Pushes it down the floor for Harler. Harler gets it in the lane. Here's Matthews attacking. Layup. It's good to the foul. Emmett Matthews down the lane. Scoring and putting West Virginia up 67-53. And the Mountaineers in this sequence have passed the ball just beautifully in the open floor. WVU continues to build on the lead. And Jay, you've got to give a ton of credit here to Chase Harler. He really got this run started with a three, came back down, hit two foul shots, and then has been really isolating inside that free throw circle, initiating offense, and really passing the ball well.
And also, it starts with the rebounding. Culver's out now, replaced by Rout. Just a little bit of rest for Culver, but right now it's just been the rebounding and the fast break, and they've gotten out ahead of Grand Canyon and finishing well.
Matthews, free throw up in. Emmett's got 11 points, and West Virginia has a 15-point lead, 68-53, 4:50 to go.
13 out of 16 from the line for West Virginia.
Drexel with the ball outside left, guarded by Harler. Harler gets a screen from Michael Finke, deals the ball near side wing. Matt Jackson with it. Jackson starts to dribble down the baseline, cut off there by Rout, back to Michael Finke. Three ball up off the rim, no rebound taken by Jordan McCabe. McCabe's pushing it. McCabe on the other end of the floor, top of the circle, flips the ball back to Haley. Haley, left side wing to Emmett Matthews. Matthews drops the ball inside. Logan Rout kicks it to the right corner. Holler, one more pass to McCabe. A three in the air, no good. Long rebound, that's Logan Rout. Kicks the ball to the right side corner. Here's another three. It's good by Chase Holler from in front of West Virginia's bench. And the Mountaineers have exploded on a 22-2 run. They're up 71-53, 4 minutes to go. On the other end, Michael Finke deals the ball left side to Milstead. Milstead behind the screen, back to Michael Finke. Shot rejected by Rout, but they'll call a foul. With 3:55 to go, we'll go to a media timeout. West Virginia on a run. The Mountaineers have opened it up to an 18-point lead, 71-53, with just inside of 4 minutes to go. We return after this. From United Bank, West Virginia's bank, proud to be united with the Mountaineers. What was a nip and tuck back and forth game here in the second half has exploded in favor of West Virginia. The Mountaineers on a 22-2 run over the last 5:24. Grand Canyon has missed 9 of 10 shots. They've not scored in 3 minutes and 40 seconds. Lead up to 18 points, 71-53 with 3:55 to go. Tonight's game being brought to us in part by Little General Stores, great prices in convenient places.
You know what, Tony, you look, and West Virginia just going through this game the whole way looking for somebody to ignite them, and it was Chase Harder off the bench, 8 points, but more than that, he did everything possible out there.
Michael Finke puts the free throw up and in. He's the transfer out of Illinois. Played 89 games for the Illini. Had a good career there. He averaged 9 points and 4 rebounds and came to Grand Canyon where he is playing with his brother. In fact, his brother committed before Michael Finke decided to leave Illinois as a transfer, post-grad. Makes both of them 71-55. Now we've got 3:50 to go in the front court. Jordan McCabe gets the ball to Chase Harler. Again, they're working him from the top of the circle. Couldn't get it to a cutting Haley. Back outside left to McCabe. Jordan gets a screen, uses it from Culver, announces the ball back into Derek. Derek in the lane, and they maul him. And that's going to be a foul against Oscar Freyer. Stopping the clock at 3:36. Derek Culver will get 2 free throws. That's 10 team fouls against Grand Canyon. Derek, 10 rebounds tonight, 7 points. Has not shot the ball well, 3 out of 9 from the field. But once again, honing in on another double-double. And the left-hander puts it up off rim. West Virginia has made shots at the line tonight, 13 of 16 prior to that miss.
Well, now, Tony, it's about clock management as you come down 3:36. You got a guard on defense. Don't give them anything easy. They're going to shoot the ball quick.
And the rebound tipped by Haley off of Michael Finke, and it will stay with WVU. So Culver comes up empty on his 2, but West Virginia able to keep the ball alive, and here in this late second half, every bounce has been going to WVU. Here's McCabe inbounding to Culver. Culver on the left block, spins. Culver looks, sends it back to the right corner to McCabe. Jordan brings the ball out front. Now the pass to Haley. Haley centers the ball up, drifts back out toward midcourt. Guarded by Freyer out there with 4 fouls. Now McCabe going to let a 3-ball fly. That one's off the rim, no. Rebound to Drexel. He pushes it over the midcourt line. Sends it left side to Freyer. Freyer on the near side wing, dribbles the ball back out front into the hands of Milstead, who had the hot hand early second half. Now to Freyer, back to the basket at the free throw line. Spins, faces the basket, negates a screen. Now looks, pinning inside, Michael Finke against Culver. Spins, shoots, misses. Culver picks up his 4th foul with exactly 3 minutes on the clock, and Michael Finke will go back to the free throw line. He'll have 2.
We'll take Logan Routh's going to come in for Culver. And I think Culver just was gassed out in this game. Just on offense, and he had 1 set there, Tony, on the offensive glass where he burned 4 shots. Couldn't get it up and over the rim.
Yeah, 3 out of 9 shooting. Michael Finke back to the free throw line. A first-team all-WAC selection. Had a strong finish to the season. Free throw up, no good. By Finke, who's at 83% on the season. He had 2 30-point games this year as Derek Culver now exits. He'll go to the bench with once again, double figures and rebounds. I don't know if we'll see him again. 71-55, West Virginia with a big lead. Finke's next one rims out. No, he missed both. Logan Rout has played well tonight. That's his 5th rebound.
There's Haley with it. Don't be in a hurry. Don't be in a hurry.
Jordan McCabe, 5 points tonight. He's not shot it well. 2 out of 10. Does have 3 assists. Now Haley at the top of the circle, looking down inside. Back out wide to McCabe. McCabe holds that ball, shot clock at 10. They get it to the foul line. Harler pushed up a 15-footer. He hit another one. How do you like Chase Harler? 10 second half points. West Virginia goes up 18-73-55, 2:25 and ticking. Milstead with a double high screen out front. McCabe goes underneath it. Milstead now, one hands the ball, left side. Matt Jackson. Jackson gives it on the left side wing. Back out to Drexel, shot clock 10. Drexel now attacks, left side of the lane, follow-away shot blocked by Logan Rout. Loose ball taken by McCabe in transition over midcourt. McCabe now works the ball out front and use some clock here. We go inside now of 2 minutes to go in the game with the Mountaineers leading it 73-55. Haley handoff. Back up front to Harler with a handoff. Dribble handoff now to McCabe between the two circles. McCabe sends the ball back to Harler. Now to the right side wing. Haley gets the ball down inside. Emmett Matthews, reverse layup. Won't go. Rebound tip. Controlled by Freyer. 1:45 to go. West Virginia with an 18-point lead. Freyer brings the ball up himself. The junior out of Oakland. Stopping, popping, pushes up a three, and he hangs it in there. Oscar Freyer with his 13th point. 73-58, Mountaineer lead is 15, 90 seconds to go, and McCabe walks the ball through the center jump circle. McCabe hands the ball over to Harler. Here's Jermaine Haley. Haley down the lane, little behind the shoulder, layup shot, good down the left side. Boy, is he something else. 22, Jermaine Haley, 14 second half. West Virginia goes up 75-58. Here's Milstead launching a three, and he swishes it from the near side wing, his 12th point.
And Grand Canyon is a heck of a shooting team. They're going to be good.
75-61, crowd reacting as McCabe walks the ball over midcourt with 50 seconds to play. 14-point WVU lead. Dribble handoff out front, Harler. One hands the ball to Jermaine Haley. Haley again, penetrating. Haley puts this one up off the backboard again on a one-hand floater. And Haley unstoppable here in the late going. 77-61. West Virginia with the big lead. 30 seconds left. Milstead penetrates, kicks the ball underneath, and Michael Finke reverse layup uncontested up and in for his ninth point. 77-63. 25 seconds to go. Jordan McCabe going to walk the ball over. The shot clock is off. And Hugs says, don't shoot it, and they'll just dribble this clock out. The freshman, Jordan McCabe, will dribble it out, and the West Virginia University Mountaineers will advance on to the second round of the College Basketball Invitational. A furious second half run by West Virginia, and the Mountaineers win it by a final score of 77-63 as Bob Huggins congratulates and shakes hands with Dan Marley.